Hey everyone, welcome to the first episode of Interview with Abhimanyu. Super excited to launch the show. Quick introductions first. Mera naam Abhimanyu hai. Main ek writer hoon, main kahaniyan likhta hoon. And for all the geniuses who haven't guessed already, main show ka host hoon. Sitting next to me, my partner, Karen. Karen is a genius graphic designer and the mastermind behind everything cool that goes at Interview with Abhimanyu. Say hi, Karen. Did you see her? No, you won't see her, ever. Because this is Interview with Abhimanyu, me. Anyway, my guest today is a fitness trainer, a nutritionist, a reiki healer, a pilates instructor, a vegan athlete. My God, this girl does so many things. A chef who makes delicious vegan desserts, not just for herself, but anyone who wants to eat it. This girl is so full of energy. She's always so positive, but don't let it fool you because once she's in the gym, she's a beast. I've seen her make grown-ass men stand on those big tires, giant tires, which are in the gym, those big tractor wale tire. And then she drags those tires. She even flips those tires, sending grown-ass men everywhere, flying. I thoroughly enjoyed my conversation with her. We spoke about women working in Indian fitness industry. We spoke about diet, nutrition, vegan lifestyle, and a lot more. It was fun. I really enjoyed it, and I hope you guys enjoy it as well. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the beautiful, the strong, Annavi Khot. Did you enjoy the conversation as well, Karen? She says yes. Annavi Khot, ladies and gentlemen. You look vibrant as ever.
Thank you.
And there's a reason, you know, gym, you are a fitness trainer, right?
Yes.
So when I see people in the gym, right? So it's not an easy job when you go inside the gym because loha uthana asaan nahi hai. You know, it's hard work, right?
Yeah.
And people are always aggressive and angry. That makes sense because they are working hard, right?
Yeah.
But somehow I've been working out with you in the same gym since I'm guessing 2 years or something.
Yeah, it's been
there. I've always seen you smile. It's like very positive, like it's like full of energy. So I just want to know, like, what goes through your head every single day when you enter the gym? Because sometimes days are shitty, right?
I mean, yeah,
sometimes you just don't feel like it.
So basically, gym and going to the gym has always been my passion.
Okay.
And when you love something, it does not seem like work. And you're always happy. So basically, it's like an escape from the world's rubbish and you're back to your happy place again, you know. So that's why I'm always smiling, I'm always happy because that's where I belong.
When I look at you, it feels like, you know, ki you have achieved that koi clarity hai tumme ki, yeah, everything will sum up into this larger picture that you have in your head. So yeah, that's it's very rare.
And the thing is, you know, when you have a vision,
yeah,
and you know, things don't always work out the way you want it to, but you still have to have the vision that what you want to achieve, that should be so clear that whatever happens, you know you're going to get there.
Yeah.
So that is important. So that's what I tell myself every day. I mean, you know, there's so many things that are unpredictable in life.
Yeah.
And there's so many things that happen which are not in our control. So the gym is like, okay, there's something which is in your control, you know.
So how did you get, I remember we had a conversation, you told me that you were into hospitality.
Yes.
So that's like hotel management?
Yeah,
or?
So I've done my hospitality management.
Okay.
4 years from Lavasa.
Alright.
I still love cooking, I still love baking. That's how I have my own brand of raw treats. It's called raw treats.
Yes, we will talk about that.
Yeah,
later, yeah.
So I love cooking and baking, that's why I joined hospitality. But I used to, even back then, I was always the first person to enter the gym.
Okay.
At 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. just to finish my workout before, you know, my day starts.
Fine.
And yeah, it used to be like that. I used to open the gym, you know, and like everyone, all the trainers were asleep. And I swear, what is going on? But yeah, that's how I started. And I used to be really overweight back then.
We've seen the
so,
pictures. We
yeah,
have stopped
you've
your
just
Instagram.
Seen, yeah, yeah,
yeah.
So that when I started working out, it was the first time when I entered the gym, you know, I got like a chill down my spine. And that's when I actually started working out with
so
weights.
Connected, right?
In a way. Instantly.
Yeah, I understand.
And
yeah.
I knew this was it. Like, come what may, I never stopped. So consistency was always there. You know, even when I was studying or was doing my hospitality, gym was like breathing to me, like it just happened. And after I graduated, I realized that okay, I will not get into hospitality per se, but this is my passion. So that's
so the
how
career shift. How are your folks, your parents back
home? Oh my god!
Because I'll tell you something. I'll tell you something. So I passed out from 12th standard in 2005 or 2006, right?
Mm-hmm.
At that time, sabko law karna tha. You know,
yeah.
Earlier everyone wanted to be an engineer
yeah.
or a doctor. Us time wo transition mein tha, everyone wanted to be a lawyer,
yeah.
right?
There was a point in my life I wanted to be a lawyer.
See, so yeah, so everyone wanted to be a lawyer, and even I didn't know. I just entered a law school because my sister was in law, and I didn't know what to do. Right,
mm-hmm.
So the writing thing to me, so I started writing way after like I don't know how many years.
Mm-hmm.
So. उस टाइम पे अगर मैं अपने पिताश्री को बोलता कि डैड आई वांट टू जॉइन द फिटनेस इंडस्ट्री इफ आई वुड हैव सेड दिस थिंग टू हिम ही वुड हैव बीन लाइक पहले तो गाली सुनाने के बाद बोला था कि क्या पहलवान बनना है आई मीन बिकॉज टाइम्स वर डिफरेंट नाउ द इंडस्ट्री हैज शिफ्टेड राइट यू सी राइट इफ यू आई हैव दिस फीलिंग दैट इफ आई गो ऑन द छत एंड यू नो थ्रो अ स्टोन वो पांच फिटनेस ट्रेनर्स को बजेगा जाके आई फील लाइक दैट बिकॉज In every block, there is a fitness. It is very tough, very
yeah.
tough. So, yeah, how did your parents react to that?
So, my dad was freaked out. I mean, till today, like, it's now that he started to support
hmm.
my dreams.
Hmm.
And now, as in 2019, January, this month. So, it's always been tough because,
right.
you know, that mentality is there, ladki hai, gym mein kaam kar rahi hai.
Right.
That is this stereotype and a mentality which I want to break. Because if just because a girl likes working out does not make her a bad person or, you know, in India especially, it's like looked down upon.
Yes.
So, I want to change that. And that is one of my visions that, you know, so that a person can be him or herself. You know, in this environment, in this society.
Because I feel there's a very small, you know, part of the society that agrees to it. Like, they let
small.
Their... It's true. People say that, okay, no, girls are doing this. But they are very... The quantity of people, girls especially, because once you enter the gym, you need proper gear. You need
exactly.
gym tights, sports
yeah.
bras, whatever you have to wear. You need
yeah.
proper dressing. And most of the parents, they don't allow.
Because
I know.
Like
yeah, yeah, exactly. They're still not open to the
they're
fact.
Still not.
Yeah, so I mean, yeah, so I'm glad that your folks said yes to it. I mean,
yeah,
yeah,
finally they did. But it was really tough, my entire family, it was really tough to break it open. There was a time when I used to tell them I'm going out, but I used to go and work. So they didn't know I had a job because I had to hide it just
All right.
because they didn't accept
That's
it.
Cool. That's
so,
cool.
So yeah, it, like if you love it, you will do whatever it is, you know, whatever what it takes to get there.
So they had no idea that unki beti jaake wait
yeah,
kar rahi hai.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they always knew I'm working out, but that like that's what I love. But they didn't know I'm working. So when I started in my initial days, when I started working
hmm.
the brand, so that time they didn't know I had a job. So I used to just be like, yeah, I'm working out, and then I have this plan. I'm
right.
going to go for my class or whatever. And they were like, okay, but then to break it to them that no, I actually have a job in a gym was very tough.
So when they, because I personally feel that this town knows you. I mean, yeah, if I know you, I mean, I came new to this town like 2 years ago, right? And I know you. So people know you. People do follow you. So did that success help, you know, change
yes,
your parents' mindset
so,
or whatever?
Yes. So
yeah?
In fact, there was an incident just yesterday.
Okay.
There was someone who came at home, a guest, one of my father's friends.
Hmm.
And he saw me and he didn't know, like, you know, that Viren Koto, he has a daughter.
Right.
So he saw me, he's like, oh my God, you're Annavi. I know you through Instagram, I know your
Fantastic.
Fitness. And I was like, okay, how do you know each other? You know, he's like, no, I know her through social media and she's
yeah.
really fit and blah, blah.
Must have been a proud feeling for
yeah,
your father,
exactly.
right?
Yeah, exactly. So these kind of incidents or moments
yeah.
really help in, you know, making it easier for your parents that, you know, it's okay if she's into fitness or it's
right.
okay if she's like... training somebody, even if it is a man or a woman.
Hmm.
So yeah.
And you are certified, right? That,
yes.
So I have no idea about this certification. So what is the process like? What do trainers, you know, go through when they say that they are certified
so
nutritionists and trainers?
Yes, every trainer or nutritionist
hmm.
they require certification,
right.
which is a valid certification.
Right.
So I did my ACSM, that's American College of Sports Medicine.
Okay.
I've done my ESA, that's International Sports Science Association.
Right.
And a certification through ESA as well of
okay.
nutrition. So I've done all that. I'm currently still studying.
So when that's good, you're still learning because people become rigid, right? They just don't let go.
And the good part about this industry is even if you have a certificate, it has an expiration date. Like my nutrition certificate expires in 2020. So I have to renew it, means I have to learn something new again.
Right. But the course is pre-decided or even they evolve?
They evolve. Right. So there's something new every year that you learn.
Hmm.
And you know, you always, in this industry especially, you have to keep yourself, you know, very knowledgeable. Because there's so many views on one particular subject.
Right.
So you don't know what's right. That's what happens to a lot of people now.
So many people, they opt for personal trainers outside the gym as well, like freelancers. So what should they look for when they are looking for a trainer? Like, I'm talking about certification, not like, you know, his or her Instagram profile. Like.
Yeah. So basically, the best certification right now is ACSM. And there are multiple ACE and all those things are there as well.
Right.
But right now, the best one is that.
Okay.
And if you're looking for a trainer outside the gym or, you know, who, you have to first see how knowledgeable the trainer
is. Right, exactly.
Because
they fool you.
Yeah. And you will never know until you start asking questions.
Right.
So ask questions about what muscle am I doing? How is it going to help me? You know, ask your trainer to give you a target and you see if you achieve it, because otherwise you're wasting your time and your money.
Back home, there was this trainer, right?
Mm.
I'm talking about Jammu. So, वहाँ पे एक ट्रेनर था, काफी ठीक लगता था, because he used to, you know, show interest. He wasn't my personal trainer. So, मैं और मेरे दो तीन दोस्त जाया करते थे. So, he was very proactive. He used to come forward and help us with form and all, whatever. So, eventually, he did show his true colors. Like, he was like, इससे आगे आपकी, he was so blunt and blatant, you know, he was like, ki isse aage aapki body nahi ban sakti. Now you need some other stuff. So you know what I'm talking about, right? So they talk about whatever, anabolic steroids.
Yeah,
I don't know. I'm still learning about it.
Yeah.
So
there are a lot of people you will come across like that. And
it's everywhere. It's everywhere.
They are so confident. And hats off to that, because, you know, the people who are actually knowledgeable don't have that much confidence. And I feel, why? You know? So, and that's how they fool you, because they're so confident, you feel, oh my God, he knows everything.
And you know, they have an effect, because a friend of mine did take it. Of course, I'm not going to name it, he'll kill me, right? But he did take a few oral tablets.
Okay.
And they worked because there was a, you know, significant change in a short amount of time. And I'm not promoting it, but there was, you can't help it,
but
right?
But there are side effects. Again.
Of course, you need to cycle
very,
it.
Like,
oh,
terrible
yeah.
side effects.
I've heard.
Even
I've,
if you cycle it or whatever,
yeah.
but there are a lot of side effects. So, basically, this is a lifestyle and you cannot mess around with something which is natural.
Right, right.
So, you can either advance yourself through a natural process or, you know, be stagnant where you are, or like you be fit, or, you know, do that. But don't go that extra edge where you know you have to do something wrong.
Yeah, you damage
because,
yourself.
Yeah, I mean, your body is a temple and you're going to literally screw it up if you do something which is not...
Let's talk bodies. I really want to talk bodies. So, when your client approaches you, man or a woman, right? So, I'm sure they have an image in their head, right?
Yeah.
Like, this is what they are looking for. That's how they want to look like.
That's right.
But for you, you know, if someone hires your services, so, aap usko kya advice doge? Or, you know, what is your perfect idea of perfect body? Like, because people go to the extremes, right? As we said. So, they damage themselves.
Yeah.
उनको एक महीने में इतने पाउंड्स लूज करना है या उनको दो महीने में इतना मसल बनाना है दैट डजंट मेक सेंस राइट दैट्स नॉट हाउ बॉडी वर्क्स
नाउ इट्स डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट पीपल आई मीन इफ समवनस इनटू अ कंपटीशन दे ऑब्वियसली नीड टू बी लाइक ओके आई नीड दिस मच परसेंटेज ऑफ फैट एंड दिस मच परसेंटेज ऑफ मसल बट इफ अ नॉर्मल पर्सन कम्स टू मी एंड सेज आई वांट टू बी फिट एंड दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू लुक लाइक फर्स्ट यू विल बी लाइक ओके सेट रियलिस्टिक गोल्स
Right.
Okay.
So you do tell them, right?
Of course, okay. yes. That's a given. You need to set realistic goals. You need to get your BMI done. You need to know what percentage of fat is in your body and how you're going to get rid of it.
Right.
And then, reach to your goal. And that happens, the 80% is nutrition. So if you're not eating right, nothing in this world can help you.
True.
Nothing. Yeah. Then it's just surgery.
Yeah.
So if you have to eat right, that's the main thing. So, if a person comes to me and be like, yes, of course, you can get to where you want to be, but you need to work hard.
So you must have heard about this moment, body positivity.
Yes.
People are talking about it. What's your take on that? I just want to know, like.
For me, a healthy body is of course, when you are, you can run, right. You can climb stairs,
right.
You can not lift 100 kgs, but you can lift something off the floor and keep it on the table and not feel
exhausted,
drained,
yeah,
you
right.
know. So for me, being healthy is that. So I will not say that you need to be a certain size,
right.
But if you're happy and you're healthy and you can do certain things, that for me is healthy. Because I myself don't, have that vision that I want to look skinny or
right.
I want to be, a certain way. If I see an image on Instagram or I see something on social media,
uh-huh.
and that's not how I feel, that's not healthy for your mind as well.
Right.
I mean, you kind of expect too much out of yourself and then you get disappointed and
True.
That leads to depression.
Yeah, exactly.
So, for being healthy is...
Then they leave the healthy routine.
Yeah,
as well.
Exactly. So, being healthy is being mentally, emotionally, spiritually, being happy. So,
this was, spreading a lot on the internet lately. So, there was this Cosmopolitan magazine cover.
Okay.
I don't know, last month or last month, I have no idea, but
mm-hmm.
there was this huge, huge lady, like she was, I mean, you will see the cover and you wouldn't hesitate to call her fat. She's fat. She's
mm-hmm.
like obese
mm-hmm.
and she's wearing a bikini
mm-hmm.
and the title says roaring fitness supermodel or something like that.
Okay.
So the idea is to promote the body positivity. Karen, can you show the image? Yeah, she's the one. Yeah.
Okay.
So her name is Tess Holiday. I'm guessing her name is Tess Holiday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And yeah, one piece, whatever she's wearing. So the article talks about, this is what people are talking about right now. I don't want to criticize body positivity.
Yeah.
Because
it's not, honestly, in this world, you cannot force someone to do what they don't like.
Yeah.
And it's all about yourself. And the problem here is they are marketing being fat and obese as, accept yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is not really right. I mean, if that woman, respectfully, I say it, if she was working on herself and, being healthy.
Exactly. If she would have posed with dumbbells and, something
like
that.
At least she's working towards it,
That would have been a body positivity
exactly.
message,
that's
right?
Exactly.
Instead, they're just, I feel beautiful under this skin. That's okay. I mean, people shouldn't bully you. People shouldn't call you
course.
Fat or
I mean,
shame you,
there was
right?
a time when people called me fat. And I have gone
I
through a lot.
That. Yeah, I've
so,
seen your pictures. I don't
yeah.
want to comment, but
yeah.
Yeah, I've seen,
but it was
yeah.
a very hard time. So you cannot insult someone like that because that emotionally...
I have heard words like fat because I didn't have any neck
okay.
and I had, I was short and
yeah,
I had
yeah.
man boobs and all. I was properly But then
so
I just...
we've been through that.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
So
it hurts. It's
it hurts
it's very degrading when someone
yeah.
calls you fat. Motu-motu to aram se ban
gaya. Self-confidence goes...
Shatters. And your fam... It's... what's worse? That your family...
Is the
will
first
never no no they won't call you kabhi gusse mein aage bol denge kum khaya kar but otherwise they won't call you that but they feel it that,
they feel it,
that, that
yeah.
the society the people the friends
That's
are calling
true.
And they feel it and they couldn't do anything about it because I was all about makhan and whatever chips so yeah so this if she would have posed with a dumbbell even
yeah.
in a gym tight doesn't matter how she looks
yeah.
that would have been a positive message
yes.
rather than
basically, conclusion to this is, no matter what you look like, as long as you're working towards being healthy,
right.
no one's going to judge you.
Right, true.
That's it. Because at the end of the day, you have to take care of yourself.
Right.
And
Makes
no
sense.
One's going to benefit but you.
Mm-hmm.
You will be healthier, you will be happier. So, that's it.
Okay, there's a little, this topic, I hope you're comfortable talking about it. So, you have a lot of women clients, right?
Mm-hmm.
The ones who want to get shredded.
Mm-hmm.
There's one problem with women who want to lose fat. They lose their breast size. It's true,
yeah.
right? They lose. So, what's the, how do they approach it? Like, are they willing to? Because there are very few.
So, honestly, there are women who don't mind.
Right.
And 90%.
What about their boyfriends?
Never got a person
do they talk about their boyfriends?
No, they don't, in fact. Because they don't care.
Because if my girlfriend tells me that, okay, I want to get shredded as fuck, right? I want good six-pack
yeah.
and all. So at the back of my head, I'll know.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be like, yeah. I'll be like, yeah. Please go ahead. But no.
The thing is, honestly, if it's a very personal thing.
Right.
So now
yeah.
there are two things which are very personal in life: is being happy and your own body.
Hmm.
So you cannot, have a thing that oh my God, what is he gonna feel?
Yeah, seek validation from others.
Yeah, because it's up to you. Now. this is a natural process and it is definitely going to happen.
Right.
Of course, it is going to happen.
Yeah.
But that does not mean that you feel... In fact, I've never got a question like that from any of my women clients.
But were they ever, like, were they willing to, you know, take it to that
yeah.
level? Because it only happens after, you know, if you drop below 12% body fat
yeah.
percentage or something like that.
So there is a healthy a range of body fat percentage that a woman should have.
Okay.
Which, you know, where you look good. And you feel good.
Right.
So now there are other women who get into competitions.
They have
so they don't have a choice and they don't mind because they know what they're getting into.
Right.
And so this is how it works. And there are so
most
there
of
are
them get
sizes.
Into implants as well, right?
Yeah,
so,
most
yeah.
of them do implants as well. I won't say anything against it or for
their
it because
wish,
yeah.
yeah,
because
yeah.
that's a very
not
personal
a big fan
choice.
Personally, but
yeah,
yeah
it's
wish,
a
yeah.
very personal choice. So
yeah.
no comment there. But yeah, many women don't mind and honestly, they don't care. So,
that's
a good thing because
yeah, yeah.
it's
I mean,
changing.
They get phenomenal bodies. Like,
yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
Yeah, that's amazing. So yeah, another thing that I really want to talk about. You're a vegan athlete.
Yes.
Yeah, how did that happen?
Wow, so...
When did that happen?
It was 3 years ago.
3 years ago.
Yeah. So, I used to eat chicken and eggs
okay.
Before that.
So, you were a non-vegetarian?
Yeah. I never used to eat red meat or fish or things like that.
Okay.
But I was always chicken or egg.
Hmm.
And so, my grandmom was my idol. And so, she was a vegetarian. And
right.
that time, I never understood. I mean, I used to be like, okay, yeah, meat, you know, like, you just
yeah,
eat. It's,
yeah, it's
tasty,
delicious.
It's yummy. And so, what happened was... when I was into fitness, I used to obviously, you have to have a certain amount of protein.
Yeah.
And, you know, that time I was not educated on how you can get your protein by other sources.
True.
And I started eating and there was a time when I started getting rashes all over my face because the uric acid in my blood, right,
okay.
that's because of excess of protein and you're not having enough water and things like that.
Yeah, you
so
have to counteract.
I went to the doctor and said, you know, this is it and all. The doctor said, you have to stop chicken, you have to stop egg. In fact, you stop all protein sources. That means mushrooms or, you know, even plant-based protein. You have to
that
stop.
Is extreme. That is
yeah,
extreme.
Yeah, because
I think that
I
is
had
extreme.
To because
yeah.
it was a lot of it. So, I did that and after that, I didn't feel like eating chicken or egg because I felt lighter.
Uh-huh.
I felt my mind changing a lot.
Okay.
I felt more clear in my thoughts. And then I got introduced. So, I was a vegetarian for a couple of months
right.
before turning vegan. I got introduced to this ma'am called Darshana. So she's a vegan activist.
Right.
And I just came across her and then she showed me a couple of videos and I was like, okay, this is not happening. I can't do this, you
yeah.
know, to animals. And since I love animals as well, I love my dogs, I love all kinds of animals. So I was like, I didn't know the dirty, nasty stuff that goes behind of having milk or having, you know, your
the
paneer
way they
and things
the
like
cattle.
That.
Yeah,
yeah, the way they treat those animals is horrible.
It is.
So, for me, changing into, like, being vegan was overnight. After I saw those videos, I didn't even feel like touching those things. And now, it's been 3 years, almost 3 years, and I'm pretty used to my lifestyle. And
but, Annavi, I'll tell you something. I've noticed one thing. I know a few vegans. It is extreme in a way. Like
mm-hmm.
if you are used to our eating habits, mm-hmm. right? In India, doodh ghee ke bina nahi
chalta
hai, makkhan ke bina nahi chalta hai.
Mm-hmm.
Chicken, obviously, if you are a vegetarian or non-vegetarian. But milk and, you know, milk products, honey, no one wants to leave honey. That's
yeah.
the thing, right? So, I have seen that, people do leave it after some time. You know, they're like, oh, I was a vegan, but
mm-hmm.
now I don't do that anymore because it was, I don't know, they see changes, I mean, they see negative effects or something like that. So they do leave it,
okay.
do leave it, and then they turn back to vegetarian. So I saw the documentaries and all,
right.
your mentor, whoever the lady is, Darshana, right?
Mm-hmm.
So she must have shown you a video or something, you know?
Yeah,
yeah. So I've seen that. It did change me for a few days.
Yeah.
It did. I had that effect, but then, you know, chicken. So I was like, yeah, it's okay. Doesn't matter. But I noticed one thing that if you ever encounter a health issue, right,
mm-hmm.
people tend to change.
Yeah.
It happened to me as well.
Yeah.
I got sick. I couldn't, doctor said that no chicken, no meat. So I left everything. So my friends started mocking me. It's a huge
yeah.
thing. You know, you have to counter
yeah.
that thing because peer pressure matters. It
I
matters.
Come from a Rajput family.
So do I. So
all non-veg
yeah,
every
yeah,
time,
exactly.
every day.
You need to have. So if you talk about Rajput families, so my family, they are... Some of them are hunters as well. So they hunt for leisure as well, and wild boars and all. So not now, because you can't do that anymore. But 10-15 years ago, pahadon mein kahin pe, so they used to, you know, hunt game. And hamare ghar mein, it was called achar. So achar was only poke. It was poke with thick fat layer. This, you know, this thick wild boars and all. So I come from that family, but I did leave non-veg for, and I've noticed that health issues are one of the major reasons why people start, you know, this journey vegan. So it happened to you, right? It happened to me as well. So how come, like, how did it become, you know, like, how did you steel yourself that, okay, now I'm not going to eat this? Or do you ever think that, will you ever turn vegetarian again?
So the thing with me is, I always have a substitute for what I want to eat. And I have the biggest sweet tooth anyone in this world can have.
Okay.
So, for me, the hardest part was not giving up milk or paneer. Because even during the time when I used to eat chicken or whatever, I never had a lot of milk because I was not fond of it.
Right.
So for me, it was not a very big transition.
Right.
But giving up desserts was something which was really tough for me. Okay. And so, but now I bake myself, and you know, there are multiple restaurants and cafes that have vegan desserts and vegan menus. So I'm okay with it.
And
now,
to catch up, I've noticed that vegans with their desserts and their foods, they put a lot of effort. They put extra effort, maybe because they have to compete with others. They are new in the market. So they make this fantastic looking dessert and all, colorful and all, and you feel like it, and they're not bad,
they're amazing.
I've tried. I take my friends to certain vegan cafes and they talk shit about it because, you know, I don't know, whatever, but I love the vegan dessert.
So there was a time when I fooled my family, so there was a dinner.
Do you have a separate fridge at home?
Yes.
I wanted to know.
I
was guessing.
Because I bake, and like, I have tons of orders that are kept in the fridge, you know, output delivery and things like
and
that.
And are you like that if, let's say, by mistake, accidentally, you taste something that has milk, do you freak out? That
No,
not like
so,
that, right?
If it is an accident, I mean, it's okay.
Yeah, you don't sweat, right?
Yeah, I mean, I will not go cry and like, break my back. Then I'm
brushed
over.
Yeah.
No, kuch nahi aisa nahi hai. But yeah, I mean, I am very conscious of what I'm eating.
Right.
And where is it coming from? So there was a time when, in fact, that you mentioned, we had gone for a family dinner. And I ordered something vegan without my cousins knowing that it's vegan. And they were nicely eating it. And like, oh my God, this is good. And I was like, yeah. And then after paying the bill, they're like, wait, is that vegan? I was like, yeah, it was. And like, oh my God, it was horrible.
Yeah.
So I was like, what? So it's just that perception, you know, just because it's vegan. And I've tried and tested it myself.
So before we go to raw vegan treats, which I really want to talk about, I really want to address another issue that is one of the major issues with vegan athletes. So how do you cope with deficiencies? Because if someone like, you know, someone who has a sitting job and walks and all, if he or she is on a vegan diet, I'm sure he can manage. But
no, in fact, even they can't manage if they're on a vegan diet.
Okay.
So when you're on a vegan plan,
right,
or you change your lifestyle,
right,
it is very, very important to do your research.
Right.
And to get, you know, hold of a good nutritionist who will make sure you reach your vitamins and daily, you know,
right,
requirements. Because being vegan, obviously, you're not going to get enough of, you know, they'll have B12 deficiencies,
right,
vitamin
yeah.
D deficiencies,
B5, B,
calcium,
yeah,
all that.
Yeah.
So I personally have those tablets. I eat those vitamins.
So
I have my multivitamin.
To save the planet, you need a proper nutrition.
Yes,
it's not easy.
It's not easy, and you require someone knowledgeable to tell you this is how you're going to get your daily requirement.
Hmm.
Because, of course, this lifestyle is, it's not easy, and you're not going to get
and,
your...
not
but
to mention,
I have a question. So is it healthy to be eating supplements?
It's not a supplement, it's a vitamin. Because see, even if you're eating that vitamin through meat, suppose B12, or you're having it through a pill, or you're having another source, it is B12 at the end of the day. So that's what.
But
so
what
like
about
how
the...
people have a misconception about protein. So now, many people tell me, is protein powder good? I was like, what is bad in it? Because if you're having meat and you're getting... From meat, you're getting 30 grams of protein,
right,
for example. From that scoop of protein, you are getting 30 grams of meat. So it's not poison that you're having.
I beg to differ, because I think I'm not a big fan of supplements, because I usually stay away from packaged and processed foods.
Yeah.
It is packaged and it is processed. And you take that on daily basis if you are into gym or not. I'm not saying that it won't help you build your muscle.
Mm-hmm.
But I just stay away from it. I'm not complaining against it. Exactly. I'm not a big fan. But what I really want to say is that if you say that, okay, this amount of meat gives you this much protein, so this amount of spinach will give you the same. Let's just say.
Exactly.
I think bioavailability, it's the term bioavailability, that also matters. So our body, I think our body can extract a lot of protein from meat. It's a fact, right? It can extract a lot of protein from this much of meat rather than, you know, or you'll have to fill yourself up with this much of food. That's why supplements come in, right? Otherwise, vegetarian food, you'll have to eat a lot, right?
Yeah,
in
of
a bulk.
Course. But that's when it depends on the person's goal also. Now, if a person that you're saying that this much meat requires, but not everybody requires that much of meat. You know what I'm saying? Not everybody requires 60 grams or whatever, 100, 200 grams of protein in a day. So everyone's requirement is different.
Right.
So if I, for example, I need to have a certain amount of protein in my body, I'll make sure I'm having 6 meals, that each meal has some amount of protein.
So you're getting the required amount.
I know that, okay, I've reached where I have to, you know. So that way...
So does this lifestyle get a bit expensive compared
very
to...
Very
it does,
especially
right?
in India. It is very expensive.
Yeah, a lot of things
I mean,
expensive,
if you buy a packet of Lay's, that's like $10. But if you go to buy an apple, that's 20. So do you see the difference?
So how did you get into baking? Let's talk about raw vegan treats. Like how did that start? I really want to know.
So I've done my hospitality, as I mentioned earlier. And I always loved cooking. I still love cooking. Cooking is something which I just, it happens naturally to me, baking and cooking. So I did my hospitality. And after that, there was a period in my life where about 2 to 3 months, I didn't work just after my graduation.
Right.
And I was looking for something to, you know, get my hands on. Like, what do I do next?
Right.
We all have that. So that time, I figured I do have a sweet tooth and I'm working out and I'm just wasting my workout having some chocolates or having a piece of cake and it's all going down the drain and I'm getting nowhere. So I started baking at home. So I tried creating new recipes and the first recipe I created was a protein bar. And so I started cooking, I started baking and I figured that why not sell it to others and give it to others. And so that's how I started giving out protein bars and then that's how I moved into a lot, like into it deeper.
Right.
And now I'm into like cakes and cookies.
So now you deliver
bread.
In the...
Yes,
like,
I do. It's
via Instagram, because Raw Vegan Treats has an Instagram account.
It does,
but how do you like manage, like circulate it? In the cafes?
No, so I ask people to come in or take it from the gym.
Okay.
Or if it's around, I just deliver it. So if it is on my way, so... That's how it works.
Right. I have a sweet tooth. I'm going to try that for sure. And yeah. So there's so much to talk about when it comes to you. Reiki healer. Like how?
Yeah.
Like how do you get time? That's my question.
I do meditate.
Okay.
But
when we talk Reiki, are we talking only on animals or humans as well?
I've done my animal Reiki healing as
well. It's called Reiki or Reiki?
Reiki. And I've done the human part of it as well.
And I've just googled it and, you know, I know a few who practice it, but never experienced it or never. So it's
and
like,
trust
you know,
me, Reiki
haath
is,
se karte hain upar wo,
yeah, just, but you don't need to be physically present also.
What?
Yeah.
Or Skype,
I mean,
Bluetooth, what? How? How does that work?
It's a very deep concept actually to grasp.
Based on chi, right? Chi, your inner.
Yeah, it's just all about positive energy.
Okay.
And like, I'm sure everyone knows that everything around you is energy. You are energy.
Yeah.
So it all works like how people say, mujhe isse achha vibe nahi aaya. What is vibe?
Yeah.
Vibe is an energy.
True.
So it all works on that. So now, animal Reiki, of course, you need to be present, you know, to do that. Of course, even human Reiki, if it is a very extreme case, like, you know, someone's really injured or like you need to be present there. But so now Reiki works is it's like more of you're not providing the energy from yourself.
Okay.
So you're providing the energy from the universe
because
the universe has good energy. So you're providing the energy from the universe and you're just a tunnel from which it goes through.
Right.
And so... To simplify it,
is it all right to say that technically you're just making the other person feel good and relaxed? Like,
yes.
You know?
Yeah.
Like, the positive thoughts
exactly,
and energy dalna
exactly.
So that he feels good. More like a placebo thing, right? You know?
Placebo is different.
Okay.
But this is different. Now, you can't change what the person thinks.
Right.
But you can change the way the person thinks. So
please explain.
For example, now if I need someone to do Reiki healing on me, I'm
right.
feeling down, and I have this back pain and it's just not going. So it is, you know, draining me.
Right.
So you issue the thoughts that have started the back pain.
Okay.
Or how it happened.
All right.
So there is this book that I read also. I'll pass it on to you.
Please.
It's called Healing by, I forgot the name of the writer, but it's called Healing.
Okay.
And dwells on issues of back pain. Okay. Just not back pain, but starts with the back pain. And it says that whatever emotional baggage that you're carrying,
right.
Your body somehow reacts to that emotional baggage in terms of a physical injury or in terms of
okay.
a physical.
So you can target particular areas of the body with that.
Yes,
okay.
yes. So, and this book is really deep. I mean, you have to believe it to
yeah.
understand it, you know. Otherwise, there are a lot of people be like, no, no.
Yeah, if someone like me who goes.
Yeah, who's a very practical
if, you know,
person.
Something's
would be
hurting.
Like,
it
no,
won't because
yeah.
I'll be like, this is not bullshit, it's not gonna
exactly.
happen. I know, I'll go with that mindset because I'll rather, you know, put a volini or something on that.
My thing is that, you know, you don't know everything in the world.
We don't.
And you have
know.
To be open to any information or anything
True.
That comes your way. Not
yeah.
necessarily believe everything,
yeah.
but be open to it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not doing
what if
you
it
any
does?
Harm.
What if it does
exactly,
work, right? yeah.
exactly. So this book really helped me and that's how I got into it. So Reiki healing, first initially when I did my course, it was all about healing yourself first.
Okay.
So of course everyone has their own emotional and, you know, traumas that they go through in life.
Hmm.
So I have my share
I've
of it.
Many.
I have my share of it as well. So when I was in a very bad phase in my life and I was into total depression
right.
and that's how I heard about this. And I was like, why not try it? Because, you know, what harm is it doing to me? And I went through it, I went did the course and it made me feel better. So I pursued it more, I studied about it more. And that's how I know that there is like something out there, that there is good energy that can help you.
Right.
So that's how I got into it.
I would want a, not a lesson, but I mean, at least I want someone to do that energy thing over me. And of course, you're a vegan, so you love animals. That's like a no-brainer. But I've seen your posts, a lot of dogs.
Yeah.
So before we come to dogs, do you like cats as well? Like,
I'm not
is it,
a cat person.
No, right? I think cats are assholes. I'm not lying. Because
so
if I love someone, right, I want the person or the animal to love me back, like a dog
yeah.
does, right? Cats are fucking assholes. I mean, they don't.
They are selfish.
They don't. They just be like, yeah, you meant to do this, you son of a bitch. Whatever.
Like,
they,
like
yeah.
I'm queen and you're supposed
exactly.
to love me.
I don't like cats. So I was worried. You know, I the second you said I don't like cats, I was like, yeah, now I can tell you. But yeah, I don't like cats. But dogs, yeah. I mean, yeah, what's your experience? You always had pets?
Always. Since I was
because I've
kid.
Never had a pet. I have no experience with dogs ever.
So I've been born, brought up in Bombay.
Okay.
And I've moved to Pune. It's about 15 years now.
Hmm.
But as soon as I moved to Pune, we got our first dog. And there was a Labrador and her name was Sheena. And we were so attached to her. And that's how I got to know, okay, you know. There is something which is like as pure as a dog.
Yeah.
And yeah.
I don't know how that feels, but I understand, yeah.
So yeah, that's how, and now I have three dogs.
Okay.
One's name is Leo, one is Jerry, and one is Peaches. So there's this indie dog that we adopted.
Uh-huh.
There's a German Shepherd and there's a Rottweiler.
Okay.
So I have these three
Rottweilers.
Dogs. They are not.
No?
Trust
because,
me.
Because
he is a big
huge,
baby.
Like big and... he's a baby right now,
he's
right? So what if he turns into a
year.
Bull? I mean,
I mean, of course, they
I've heard he
wise.
Eats kids like that. That
oh. That's how you train them,
yeah.
you know?
So yeah,
like
that
if
matters.
If I train
right?
him to go and kill somebody, he'll do it. And if he's trained...
Can we do that? I mean, why not? But you should, like, self-defense, I mean, in a way. Like, there should be a go code, right? Okay. So, dogs, I have a question when it comes to dogs. So... if one day I wake up and I'm a dog, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying. I'm this beautiful, gorgeous Siberian husky, right? So, you know, people have this habit, dog lovers, especially dog lovers, right? I've seen a lot of guys, girls, whatever, when people are out with their dogs, right? So dog lovers, they just surround the dog and they just, you know, caress the dog, they pet him. So I want to know, see, if I was a dog and this pretty lady comes and she's like, oh, my baby, I would enjoy it. I would love it. Once, twice, yes. But thrice, I don't know. Choose anyone. Scarlett Johansson comes and I'll fucking snap. I won't like it. But I've seen people, I mean, there's this pub in Koregaon Park, North Main Road, right? So they have this boxer sitting always. I don't know whether they have it right now or not. But and you know how pubs are in Koregaon Park, right? Especially North Main. They're like packed, right? So everyone was coming and playing with the dog. And do dogs really like that much? I mean, don't they get pissed? I really want to know.
Who doesn't love extra affection?
No, but I'm talking tens of people like coming in, you know.
And
oh,
it depends,
my baby.
You know, this actually depends on dog's personality.
Okay.
Like, if I have a dog who's always been isolated.
Right.
And then like tons of people going and like hovering over him.
Okay.
He will hate it. He'll snap. But if I have a dog who has always been around a lot of people, he will love it. So it's how they've been...
All right.
So it's that.
So it's wrong to, you know, just, you know, stereotype that, okay, all dogs are like...
Exactly,
yeah,
of
okay.
course.
I've never had a pet, so yeah, I really want to know.
You need to see my dogs, really.
No, but you should train them to kill people. That you should. And yeah, finally.
Kill him?
And yeah, Pilates.
Mm-hmm.
How did that come up? Okay, another thing. How do you find time? Because I remember, you... Are you opening... a personal studio, like a place of your own, because I saw machines and all. First thing, I don't know what Pilates are, right? I think it's this modern form of stretching for celebrities. Only because, you know, they go on.
It's something similar to yoga, not
okay.
exactly the same, but
uh-huh.
movements and, you know, the breathing and the techniques. And so it's more about stability, flexibility,
okay.
Core strengthening. That's what Pilates is all about.
So you use more of your stabilizers?
Yes,
as well. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So
okay.
anyone who's injured or, you know, they can't work out or they can't just step into the gym,
right.
for them Pilates is super. So
okay.
it also helps in, like, you know, getting a posture right. The way you stand, the way you sit,
okay.
all that. So that's what Pilates is. And I came across of that when I was working out, I needed some change. I was like, I want to try something new. And so I heard about a lot of Pilates institutes and things like that, but something close to me that's in around Kalyani Nagar. So I found Moshimi and I went and I trained with her for a month.
Mm-hmm.
And I did the reformer Pilates. I was like, this is really interesting. And I could see, I could feel it on myself, you know, that how my body's changing. So I was like, why not teach it? Why not learn it? And then I did my course of level 1, 2, 3, 4 and
okay.
now I started teaching Pilates as well.
So it's not for, you know, mostly people are crazy about muscle building, right? They want
yeah.
So it's not for that, like, you know?
No.
Toning
more,
or...
Yeah.
So, you know, all those big biceps, big butts and all, it's not going to work for those people, right? You know, poses on Instagram.
No.
It's a glamorous world out there.
That's weights.
Pilates gave me that
I
butt. It's not
going to...
No. Yeah, that's weights. That's weights. That's squats.
Those
yeah,
are squats, yes.
Yeah. And so, does it help in, you know... So, it is a form of yoga, right? So, it will help in some kind of, you know, circulation, detox, whatever.
Yeah, yeah, it does help.
I mean, every exercise does, but yoga has a very profound effect on your
yes,
circulation
yes,
and all, right?
Yeah.
So it's something similar to
similar,
that?
But in Pilates, it's more about balancing and, you know.
And breathing control, is
yeah,
it like
breathing
that? Yeah,
control.
So, yeah.
So you're just, you won't have any other thought in your mind, but to, okay, I should make sure I don't fall off.
Okay.
So you need that control, that stability and all that comes through, like, whatever exercises you do on the reformer or during Pilates mat
right.
classes. So that's what.
Mm-hmm. And have you got any clients? Like, are people really looking forward to Pilates?
They are, because they are curious,
okay.
first of all. And so what I've done is I've started these classes. It's called P-Funk. Now, since I, my majority or like my forte is weights and functional training,
right.
I try to incorporate them in Pilates.
Okay.
So I started these classes twice a week. And where I teach mat Pilates, which is mixed with a bit of functional and a bit of weights.
So that's your thing, like you invented this.
Yeah, yeah.
And are there any, you know, people always complain, right? I mean, even if it is beneficial, people will find some flaw and they'll say like, okay, that's dangerous or whatever,
mm-hmm.
you shouldn't do that.
So
I mean, is it okay to improvise?
Yeah, of course, why not? And since you're sticking to the exercises which are, you know, accepted by... the American College of Sports Medicine,
right.
you're not doing something vague with someone's body,
uh-huh.
It's fine. I mean, it's not something new that I've done. I've just mixed up, I've just clubbed a few things in. So it's like I'll give some squats with weights, and then for functional, I'll give them some burpees. For Pilates, I'll give them some hip movements.
Right.
So it's all combined together. So in the end, they get fat loss. The stability is there. The control is there. The core is strengthened. Everything's done.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Still not doing Pilates. That's weird. I know. Something doesn't allow. I think we've covered everything. You told me about this habit of reading, right? I remember.
Yeah.
So what are you reading? Like,
so
it's more like self-help and books like that?
Self-help, motivating books,
right.
But also the one which I was talking about, healing.
Uh-huh.
A lot about
okay.
body.
Okay.
I read a lot about what goes on inside the body. So I have lots of books for that as well.
I think one should really know about, I often tell her that, like, one should really know about, you know, the gut. Like, you should really study your gut.
Yeah, yeah.
And its functions, you know, that's the main thing.
That's the main thing.
That's
yeah.
like the biggest 35-40 feet thing inside your body. Yeah, people just ignore it. Somehow, it's very weird that most of the, you know, diseases or whatever, people just ignore food somehow.
Yeah.
Have you noticed? People
yeah.
don't, even doctors don't, you know, ask that, what are you, they say, okay, antibiotics, eat whatever you want to,
because
right?
Because they're making money.
yeah, they are, shitloads
of
money.
It is a shitty world now.
Yeah, medicines. So, yeah, I mean, I like medicines if I have some, you know, if I have a scratch or a burn or if it's a trauma, like whatever,
yeah.
you know, something that, but a chronic disease, something people aren't eating right for the past 10, 20 years. I was a victim, right? I was always on Momos, Maggie
yeah,
and all this
exactly.
stuff, like cheese and all. And then you get some disease and then you say that, you know, medicines aren't working or
yeah,
something. It won't work
so
because
it
damages your friends. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So your books are about...
Yes,
yeah.
a lot about food, a lot about nutrition, a lot about what happens, you know, when you eat a certain food or things like that. A lot about the things that are happening inside the body.
Uh-huh.
And of course, I do read... I hate reading any fiction or all that. That's like, I feel it's really...
No, that's it. Back. We're done.
I mean, that's my personal opinion.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like reading. My God, you're defensive. But yeah, I don't like reading those kind of books. I like reading something which is...
Top one, you know?
I know,
really,
I just saw that. Very realistic book. Something which,
I
you know, also...
Yeah.
Maybe some about like a biography on someone who is, you know,
those are inspiring,
gone
yeah.
through
yep.
so much and achieved so much in life.
Yeah.
So those kind of books I love reading.
I think you should write a book on your gut.
On my gut.
On guts.
On guts.
Yeah.
I can. I've researched a lot. But it's a good idea. But yeah, another thing I remember, we had this short conversation in the gym once. So I remember you were on the squat rack, I guess, and I just asked that, do you do, you know, isolation? And you were like, huh. You remember, you were like, huh.
Yeah.
So why is that? Because I think even isolation, you know, what do
I
you...
wouldn't say no, but
yeah.
for my
it's
body type and for
okay.
a woman,
okay.
especially now, of course, a bicep curl would not help a woman as much as a squat would,
yeah.
So
Unless you want big biceps, right?
Yeah,
if
I mean, you have to train smart and it depends on your goal as well.
Yeah.
So, basically, if you want overall fitness, so you have to focus on movements like squats, deadlifts.
So, you don't say it's useless, right?
No, I would never.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
I would not say it's
that's,
crap,
that,
but...
That's the vibe that I got in that. I'm like, oh, I was like, maybe.
No, but I personally don't like
yeah.
just standing there and, you know...
Pehelwangiri.
Yeah, I like something which challenges me a lot.
Yeah,
so
I understand.
If I'm doing a... So, for me, the favorite exercises, what I love, are squats, deadlifts.
Deadlifts. Yeah, the main,
yeah,
major
these,
muscles.
These two
yeah.
are like, hands down, my
right.
favorite. So,
and I always see you, you know, hanging upside down and all, like handstands and all.
So, yeah, I want to... So, my new goal, basically, for this year is to try and get into a little bit of calisthenics.
Okay.
And, you know, I want to get stronger and I know my weak points in my
right.
body. So I want to get stronger in those areas and I want to see what my body is capable of. I mean, I didn't know that I could hang upside down, you know, with those Roman rings or things like that. But I can do that. So I want to see what more I can do. And
yeah.
there's a different feeling to it, you know.
Yeah, the moment you achieve that.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's a very
yeah,
different
it,
feeling.
Because I remember, I'm not that into, you know, functional and all. But I did try muscle-ups and I kept on trying. So I have this mentality. I don't want to go every single day and do muscle-ups, right?
Yeah.
But I pick something up and then I get obsessed with it. So I want to do this. I remember even Dhruv was watching when I was doing this thing in MultiFit, right? So I kept challenging myself. Okay, one more time. I did that 20 times, 30 times, you know. I was like, fuck my workout. I don't care. I'm going to do one. I just want to do one.
Yeah.
So somehow after half an hour, I was tired and, you know, I took some rest and also on one arm and all, I managed. So when you achieve certain things, right?
Yeah.
So I didn't try it after that. It was like, ho gaya, haan, bas ho gaya, check mark. I don't want to do that. It's a lot of effort. So so once I did that, the world does change, right? You know, yeah. your perception changes when you achieve something like flag or whatever. Yeah. Though these exercises, I don't think they help you build your muscles. They're more like a demonstration.
So
like,
basically, so you need a strong
body,
core.
Yeah, core.
You
to do that.
You need a strong, body or like strong shoulders to do things like that.
Right, right.
So, yeah.
I think we've covered it all. And you have a website as well. It's
yes,
called,
I just launched it.
Yeah.
It's annavikhot.com.
Annavikhot.com.
Yeah. And,
you provide training, nutrition.
It can be training, nutrition, tips, pilates workout, fat loss programs.
And your desserts as well.
My desserts, you can place orders online now. And so that's what's going to start by the end of this month.
Perfect. And it was great talking to you. And it was fantastic. I loved it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.